ragazze. And when I say hold yourself, I want all of you getting ready to stop.
Hi, I'm Angela, this is Discover RPG, and hello, friends in chat. I'll turn this down a little bit, I'm sorry. Hello, hope you're all doing well today. I am having a pretty good time. Gonna probably turn off the, let's turn off the electro swing. Go for something a little more chill. Well, hello, howdy, hi to you. So today, on Discover RPG, I am working on trying to wrap up a map. This is a city that I've been developing for a for one of my games, and it is the city of Bellkeep. It is a place that I'm very excited to continue working on. It requires me to do a little bit of sort of nitpicky work. Currently, yeah, pretty much. Let me know if the volume's too loud on the music. Oops. Accident. So. I am working on... Okay, let me turn it up. Some people say it's too loud when I don't have it set up very loud. So let me know if that's audible. Can you hear anything now? This creepy face hidden in the depths, and people didn't know it was there, and it makes me happy. So, I want. So, we're gonna be doing some stuff here. Specifically, I'm going to be. Yeah, it's fun. It's a fun little detail. So if you have any questions or anything you want to know more about on the map, please let me know. Hello, Chris. So, the Sea Goddess was one of the founding, beings of Bellkeep, and it's kind of a love or a star-crossed version of. No, you're fine. This is not for shenanigans, Chris. You're good. I really dug this idea of creating almost like a Romulus Remus sort of history of a city. And so I came up with this idea of these two goddesses who were sort of the founding influences of this desert city. And their names have been lost to history, but they are a goddess of the forge and a goddess of the sea. And they were lovers, and, the wild gnome goddess has already made an appearance. They're part of a storyline with one of my private games. The idea being that they are there to be a sad story about why there's a giant hole in the middle of the bay. It's kind of just a story. The goddess of the sea went out to like roam around the ocean and she never came back. And the goddess of the forge was very sad, and she forged a bell in an attempt to get her lover to come back and kind of like call her home. And a storm raged and sank the boat that was delivering the bell she had created. And so it sank to the bottom of the bay, and she is in mourning for her lost love. It's very sad. They say when if one understands heartbreak or listens very carefully, they can hear the bell calling her home. Dun dun dun. But fear not, though this is a sad gay story, and I buried my immortal gaze, not only in that one moment, there is a lot of gay in that game. Fear not, there is much, much to be had. So anyway, just working on making these cliffs pretty cool. And if I can do that, will be kind of nice. Like that. Hi, Lane. I'm just working on trying to wrap up Bellkeep a little bit. Just in the middle of the sad story about the goddesses. Yeah. Okay, so here's the problem is I like this statue, but like that's also where I want the grave temple to be. Just feels weird. Mm. don't know about that. So I did just find out that I believe Incarnate just came out with, fully rendered houses? Gotta figure out where that is. It's pretty cool, though. I'm gonna have to play around with that a bit. Once I find it. It's not gonna be in the watercolor area. Yes, exactly, Mitch. They just came up with a bunch of tattered stuff. Oh, horses. There's horses. Oh, that's nice. Where are you at, fully created buildings? Found a killer bit of work somebody did making something out of pieces. It was very, very exciting. They made some really cool shit out of the boiler stuff. There we go, composite buildings. So these are new. Like, full-on rooms that are pre-built. And you can just put stuff in them. I'm very excited. I can't use them right now, but I am excited about them. Anyway, so what I want is a temple. I'm gonna go with a death temple. That's something that kind of feels a little like a... I want a graveyard. Collection of graveyards, gravestones. Oh, it doesn't look like they have anything. Those might work. Oh, there we go, tombstones. That's what I wanted. was it that I was looking at? I had posts. Let's see if I can remember. Sorry if I'm a little less talkative today. Just, my brain's a little nothing right now. My brain is just a little bit of mush today. I'm just looking for long stick things that I can use as the posts. Ooh, these are perfect. Broken palisade pieces. This one, and did that one, and that one. Cool. Cool, cool, cool. Alright, so. Here's what we're doing. We're taking these and we're going to select all of them and we're going to lower their brightness and their saturation and up their contrast a little bit. And we're going to make them all very tiny. Sort of stick up in the ground or in the water. So Sorry if I take a few times to save. Just want to make sure that this is, this is backed up as much as possible. I can barely see that. Thank you, Mouse. I try. I'm trying. I feel pretty good about it, too. It's taken a few weeks, months, let's be honest, for me to learn the basics of this. I've seen people that are just, like, so flippin' good at this. Even better than you think I am. Thank you both. Well, I appreciate that. Thank you. All right. So, It's sort of abandoned. It's meant to be the... It was the resting. It was meant to be the place for the bell. It's just this abandoned temple. Let's get a little smaller than that. Don't want these upside down. There we Sorry. Don't overstrain your eyes, friends. Good night, whiskey. Pupper's going to bed. Not interesting enough for him. I understand. I don't blame him. I don't have names for the neighborhoods, Franz. I do know that there is the upper tier and the lower tier. Try that again. Oh yeah, that's off the map. They're far from Bellkeep. They're like an hour's ride, I said. Well, the Sunken Archives is still being worked on. There's multiple floors, but the main point is to give you a gist of what it's like. So yeah, it is pretty much almost done. I don't know what you guys are gonna see next. Kind of depends on what y'all decide to focus on next. Well, with Goonies, I just kind of knew what I was gonna make. Because I was gonna I was gonna do a map and I really wanted to do pumpkins. Ooh, sure. The temple in Utvik. I have a map of Utvik, but I didn't make it. So I could try to remake Utvik. And just to have my own map of it. Could do that. And then the northern temple in the mountains. The one where Salune's avatar lives. Near the village. Near the Shadowclaw village. I didn't tell you that Zalbar has a last name. Or rather, he has a clan name. I just made it up, Mouse. Don't feel bad. Yeah, you decide whether you want to go talk to Selune's avatar. She might want to hear what you have to say. Seems likely that she'd want a heads up on that. Oof, Ashport. That's gonna be a time. Alright, noted. Keep that in mind for when I get back after my trip. We'll do that. For now, my brain's a little busy with something that may or may not be going on. Network starting June 1st. Dun dun dun. I actually have a map already for the Artemis. I have a ship that we can use, so don't actually have to build that. I think I showed you. I bought a bunch of maps, like a big set of them, and they included a ship. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Franz. I appreciate the hype. The hint / hype. I appreciate that. I have some things I want to wrap up on it, and we'll be ready to submit. Dun dun dun. But I felt like I needed to stream as promised first. Same, we're all really excited. And we're very close to launching, so. I mean, that's part of it. That's part of it, Mitch. Much like Cinderhaven is almost done, it's just hard to do the final touches. It's hard to do the final touches on Valkeep as well. It's kind of hard to look at it. It's just, Okay. Alright, I'm gonna take a break from this for a little while. Do something different. Just get my brain working in a different way. I'm a little tired. It's almost like I worked for like 12 hours yesterday. Battle map.
Let's check out this cool.
Oh, I'm terrible. God. Let's check out these pre-built buildings. Simple composites. What do we have here? Well, this is nice. I like this. Oh, I like that very much. What does this one look like? That's a slightly bigger house. No. And then that's a simpler house. Oh, I like this one. That is very cool. That to just have a thing like that. Oh no, Franz. What you're talking about, Mouse. I don't know what you're talking about. Not at all. I was literally about to do this. Hilarious. I'm gonna put a floor, Mitch. Don't worry about the colors, it's just the defaults. This track is called Sweet Glimpse. You all right? Thank you. So what's nice is I can lock this simple house down, and that'll just let me change the outside to be more fitting for the climate. So there, it'll like match a little better. Okay, so we got snow, and we'll do snowy wooden stairs. Love it. And then change that to stone and take that over. Pimble. GB would be fun. Serious answer? Probably Pimple. He's definitely got the most attitude to share. Sill, or oh yeah, I could see Jovian poetry. The Cadence Sisters. Guy DeVale. Jovies is just a it's just a map of all the good places to eat around. Nonsense, but you know you'd read it. Nonsense it may be. Not saying it's not nonsense, it totally is. Good night, Franz. Thank you for all your hard work. Too many axes. All right, so I'll keep working on this in the coming weeks. Momina writes the bestiary. Yep, Lane got it. 10 points to Lane. Done with the basics of the exterior. I think we got everything here. Let's do one more tree. Okay, cool. All right. So. Big fireplace. I don't have a problem with that mouse. As a example here, it's not a super small house. And then
gonna go with. For a bedroll. I'm surprised I didn't have one. Oh my god. Oh no, I'm just amused. Okay, sure. You might have to stay outside now that Trace is much bigger. Crib now. It's cute. It's a bit royal looking. Bale of hay, target practice. There's some neat stuff in here now. Oh shit, how cool is that? Oh, that looks awesome! I didn't know there was obsidian shit. Well, keeping that in my back pocket. My goodness. Ew, why are there so many cockroaches? Gross.
There we go. That's what we wanted. Matt. It's an altar, Lane. If Mamita wants to be mean and break Zelbar's little prayer area, that's her prerogative, but that would be very mean of her. I understand, Mouse. You're fine. I am good for tonight. Got a nice little bit of brain cleansing. Cute little gnome house in the woods. All right, well, thank you all for coming to Discover tonight. Still going to work on this, but we've got our little cabin in Utvik. You're welcome, Mouse. I'm excited about it. All right, well, I will hopefully talk to you all soon. We have shenanigans tomorrow night. I'm very excited. And we have some announcements coming out in the next few days. Please keep an eye out here on Twitch or on Twitter for announcements about our new Kickstarter. And we will see you all next time. Please have a good night, have a safe evening, and make good choices. Have a good weekend, have a good Memorial Day if you're celebrating or if you have time off. And please do me a favor and be good to each other. All right, friends. Good night. Mwah.